Welcome, and thank you for joining the presentation today. I'm Vince Ippolito, Executive Chairman of Botanix Pharmaceuticals, and I'm excited to provide an introduction to the company and some insights to the number of upcoming value inflection milestones we're working towards in the months ahead. Botanix is a pharmaceutical company developing products in the areas of dermatology and antimicrobials, which leverage the unique properties of cannabinoids, or CBD. Now, we've all heard about cannabinoids, and CBD is just one of the class of molecules which delivers new anti-inflammatory and antibacterial properties that have the potential to provide safe and effective treatments for common dermatology diseases, such as acne, but also addresses the challenges of bacterial resistance. In an environment where serious infections present the next major challenge for our world, I want to take you through the programs that Botanix is developing in each of these areas, introduce you to the team that we've assembled to address these challenges, and talk a little bit about the near-term catalyst for the company, which we will believe deliver substantial value to our investors. I've mentioned in the introduction that we're focused wholly on synthetic and pure versions of CBD, cannabinoids. Synthetic CBD is our major focus. In the last 2 years, Botanix has shown in phase 2 clinical studies that synthetic CBD is very safe, has proven anti-inflammatory properties for acne lesions, and can kill staph and also resistant staph, MRSA, and those bacteria don't develop resistance to synthetic CBD. This is one of those rare opportunities in the pharmaceutical area where a well-established safety profile allows us to increase the dose without dramatically increasing side effects. So we see a significant opportunity to both pursue a range of diseases with synthetic CBD, as well as drive the dose to help identify applications in dermatology and bacterial infections for the molecule. Which leads me to the development pipeline for Botanix, as you see illustrated on the screen. I'll talk in detail about each of the programs, but for ease of reference, we've divided them between the dermatology platform in orange and the antimicrobial platform in purple on the slide. I'll talk first about our antimicrobial platform and the recently commenced phase 2A study with BTX-1801. Then I'll circle back around and talk about our dermatology program following the recent successful FDA meeting and the pending commencement of our rosacea phase 2 study. One of the unfortunate consequences of COVID-19 that we've all been living through is that we all now really believe in pandemics. Now, obviously, the current pandemic was caused by viral infections, but bacterial infections present just as much of a danger to the community, and the tools we currently have to fight bacterial infections are severely outdated. The World Health Organization, or WHO, recently published a report that forecasts the deaths from infections by bacteria that are resistant to the current suite of antibiotics. They will exceed cancer deaths by 2050 and cost the global economy more than $100 trillion. And this is not something that might happen. This is an actual forecast of the current rate of expansion of the existing pattern of antimicrobial resistance to well-known bacteria like staph and MRSA. Because there's been basically no new drug classes approved to treat serious infections in the last 30 years, bacteria figured out a way to mutate or render less effective the existing antibiotics that we have, and worse, transfer that resistance to other bacteria so they could become immune from commonly used antibiotics as well. Killing resistant bacteria quickly before they could change to resist antibiotics and also killing those bacteria in a novel way are the two key goals of the new antimicrobial development programs. This slide highlights some of the data that we announced today to the market, which is the result from some preclinical studies we recently completed, which we took a look at the efficacy of our BTX-1801 synthetic CBD product in the killing of MRSA or drug-resistant staph. To make this study as relevant as possible, we took freshly harvested human skin from abdominoplasties and infected that skin with MRSA for 2 hours. And then treated the infected skin with increasing concentrations of CBD in the BTX-1801 formulation. As you can see on the right-hand panel, after just 1 hour all the way out to 24 hours, we see significant reductions in bacterial counts and, at the highest doses, complete eradication of the drug-resistant staph bacteria at 24 hours. Studies in mini pigs also confirmed that direct application of BTX-1801 to the nasal passage was very safe and well tolerated. So combined, we have shown rapid bactericidal activity, drug-resistant staph, complete eradication in the clinically relevant human skin model of infection, and BTX-1801 was safe when applied nasally in animal safety studies. These results give us great confidence that BTX-1801 will be a valuable treatment option for the prevention of post-surgical infections. So you're probably asking yourself, well, that's very interesting, but how exactly does synthetic cannabidiol kill resistant bacteria so quickly and effectively? We're leading the world in generating data to answer that question, including the exciting new data we released today. What we found from our studies, best demonstrated here in these time-lapse videos, for the first time, you'll be able to see that synthetic CBD kills bacteria by rapidly disrupting the bacterial cytoplasmic membranes in as little as 10 minutes. In both videos, the bacteria are initially surrounded by green fluorescent dye. Exclusion of the dye means the bacteria are alive and well. Uptake of the dye means the bacteria cell membrane has been disrupted and they're dying. On the left here, we have staph bacteria treated with negative control. Well, the bacteria are happy and rapidly multiplying over the 120 minutes of time-lapse video. No uptake of the dye. On the right, the staph bacteria area treated with synthetic cannabidiol, as you can see, the bacteria immediately start to die, evidenced by the rapid uptake of dye and eradication of the bacteria. Extremely impressive data. Our first target to leverage the rapid killing resistant bacteria is in the area of surgical site infections, which are the most frequent complication in patients undergoing surgery today. Not only are these infections a cause of hospitalization and death for patients, the impact on the health system is significant in terms of readmission resources, cost, and also penalties that hospitals have to pay in respect to these infections. Preventing a single case of surgical site infections could save a hospital as much as $60,000, but they can also be penalized for a portion of their total revenue from the government for poor infection control performance. Because resistance to commonly used antibiotics in this area can run as high as 95% in some hospitals, finding a new antimicrobial, which is effective and doesn't come with resistance or safety issues, is a significant opportunity in a drug development program. Our study to test BTX-1801 has recently commenced in Western Australia after the delay caused by COVID-19. This study is a phase 2A clinical trial, which will compare two different formulations of BTX-1801 against the vehicle formulations, each in healthy volunteers. So you might ask, why healthy volunteers if it's a 2A efficacy study? Well, more than 80% of all surgical site infections that occur in hospitals actually come from the patient's own nose or anus having the operation. It's not a dirty scalpel or poor maintained operating room. So what we've been able to do here is to look for healthy volunteers who have staph or MRSA in their nose rather than surgical patients with the same bacteria, and simply see over a period of 28 days whether we've been able to reduce or kill those bacteria after only 5 days of treatment with BTX-1801. We kicked off the study a couple of weeks ago and will be finished recruiting in early Q4 of this year. So our expectation is that the results from the study will be available shortly after. We already have received the FDA's Qualified Infectious Disease Designation status for this program, which will provide us an extra 5 years of regulatory exclusivity upon a successful approval. We'll also be seeking fast-track status for the development program in the coming months. We're really excited about this study because it's the first big human proof of concept study that we're doing, which not only paves the way for further development in this area of our antimicrobial platform, but will also demonstrate that synthetic CBD is effective at killing bacteria that's also involved in many common dermatologic diseases. That's a great segue into the introduction of our dermatology products that are getting ready for late-stage clinical trials in acne and rosacea, respectively. BTX-1503 is our synthetic cannabidiol product for the treatment of moderate to severe acne that completed a phase 2 study in the second half of 2019. In early July of this year, we completed an end of phase 2 meeting with the FDA to discuss the data from that study and request some guidance on the design of the phase 3 program. The FDA was very comfortable with the safety profile of BTX-1503 and even provided us with some waivers in respect of the studies that you would normally have to complete as part of a development of a dermatology product in acne. We were also able to gain some agreement that our proposed phase 3 design studies involving both dual endpoints in reduction of inflammatory and non-inflammatory lesions was acceptable by the agency. This is an important milestone for our acne program as we now have clarification on the activities required to support a new drug application for BTX-1503. Our phase 2 rosacea study, which is pending, will also inform our final design for the phase 3 BTX-1503 studies. And the timetable for which we'll kick these studies off will also be influenced by the COVID-19 restrictions, as well as we need a number of sites throughout Australia, New Zealand, and the US to recruit patients to complete the study. The good news is that the market for prescription acne products remains robust, and we still have not had a new acne drug with a novel mechanism of action approved in more than 25 years. So the market is ready for a safe and effective topical treatment that can have an effect on inflammatory and non-inflammatory acne pimples and provide some relief for the millions of teenagers and young adults around the world who suffer from this disease. I mentioned our rosacea program, BTX-1702, in the context of acne, and we're still anxiously looking forward to kicking this study off once the COVID-19 restrictions ease and we can access some of the states in Australia and potentially New Zealand to get the trial underway. Following the insights we've gained from our acne program, rosacea is a natural target for us to leverage the inflammation-reducing properties of synthetic CBD to help reduce the redness and embarrassing flushing that comes with rosacea. Rosacea is a chronic inflammatory skin disease that often begins with triggers to flush with redness more easily than other people, but can progress into many subtypes, including papular pustular rosacea. Papular pustular rosacea is a highly visible and chronic inflammatory skin disease where the patient gets acne-like breakouts across the face. And this is a disease that affects more than 16 million Americans. Women are more likely to have rosacea than men, and more than 85% of the patients are over the age of 30. This is a group of active treatment seekers looking for a new solution to rosacea. It's a significant market and a great complement to our acne program. We've been updating the design of the study and we'll try to work around the restrictions that the current shutdown imposes, but our current thinking is that we'll test two different formulations with vehicle controls with about 60 patients on drug and vehicle respectively over 6-week treatment period. Our hope is that we can get this study underway in Q4 in at least a few of the Australian and New Zealand sites and really drive hard to recruit the 120 patients total required to complete this study. As I conclude, I wanted to quickly point out the exceptional team I have behind me at Botanix, who between them have been responsible for 4 out of the 5 drugs originally developed in Australia that have achieved FDA approval, as well as our advisors who bring unrivaled expertise in dermatology and antibiotic drug development. We've slimmed down our organization in the past few months and really focused the team on achieving successful outcomes in the near-term antimicrobial and rosacea clinical studies. So we're primed for some exciting outcomes in the quarter ahead. Botanix is very well funded with approximately $24.6 million in the bank at the end of the financial year and another $6 million or so dollars expected from the R&D tax refund. We're targeting completion of BTX-1801 phase 2 study in Q4 of the calendar year and hoping to kick off our phase 2 rosacea study before the end of the year as well, both of which are important milestones in the company's development. In parallel, we're progressing our planning for the phase 3 clinical program for acne and eagerly awaiting the results of 2 phase 2 studies to finalize the design of those programs in the new year. We're really excited about the near-term catalyst for Botanix and welcome you to consider the company as an investment opportunity as we drive towards our near-term milestones. Thank you.